So God established an eternal priesthood through Jesus and gave him the power of an endless life. We know that when before Jesus came in the days of Moses, you had the Levitical priesthood. And that priesthood, they did what God ordered them to do all the days of their life. But there was a change of priesthood. Hallelujah. And the change of priesthood was that God decided to stop using the priest from the tribe of Levi. And he had a priest in his mind. Hallelujah. Who would establish an eternal priesthood. Now, a priest is one who stands in the place of intercession for God's people. And they offer both gifts and sacrifices. And they make intercession for the people. Now, God sent Jesus from the tribe of Levi. He came from the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Another priest sprang out of the tribe of Judah. And this priest carries in himself the power of an endless life. So the priesthood being changed, we now stand in the priesthood of Jesus, who is from the lion of the tribe, who is the lion of the tribe of Judah. And so Jesus is from the Judean priesthood. Hallelujah. Which means praise. Come on, put your hands together and bless him. For we are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, called for to show the praise of him who have called us out of darkness into this marvelous light. Come on, somebody bless him. Because it is evident that the Lord sprang out of Judah. Now this is a dispensation of the priesthood of Judah, the Judean priesthood. So praisers, when you stand to praise, you are basically leading Judah into praise. Hallelujah. They should come with a praise. But unfortunately, the people of God, many of the people of God do not yet understand who they are. Because the day we see who we are, we will realize that it's a whole priesthood of praise. Hallelujah. And our responsibility is to offer up gifts and sacrifices. We are made of a part of this priesthood that has it's an unchangeable priesthood. This priesthood is not made after the order of carnal commandments, and nothing was wrong with those commandments at that time. So God has given us endless life. Somebody shout endless life. Endless life. Now everybody, now this is a secret, you need to listen. Everybody is appointed to live forever. Everybody is appointed to live forever. The question is, where and with whom? Hallelujah. And it's only two. You will be eternally with God or eternally in the lake of fire with the devil. God has determined that there is a people whose lives will be in Christ. And today we shared that being in Christ is your free eternal life assurance plan. Hallelujah. That free eternal life assurance plan, excuse me, you can't pay for it. It is priceless. Hallelujah. And guess what? It is priceless because it was paid for by the blood of Jesus. We are going to be going as a church through the book of Hebrews. Oh my God, this book takes you into a look, takes a look at Christ. Jesus paid to get this priesthood established. Your function as a priest is more important than your natural career. Your natural career is a platform on which you should stand as a priest every day, offering gifts and sacrifices for God. This is why we know that God's blood is powerful. It says, how much more if the blood of bulls and the sprinkling of an heifer could to do some sanctification, temporarily cover? Hallelujah. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through his eternal spirit offered himself without spot. Purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. You know why I need to preach the gospel? I have compassion because there's a whole lot of people whose conscience were purged from dead works to serve the living God. But because they never knew what happened at salvation, them sell out them salvation cheap. And they don't understand the power of an endless life that we have. The eternal spirit, Christ is an eternal spirit. Christ is not Jesus' last name. It is Jesus who lived in Christ, the eternal spirit. Christ, the eternal spirit, stepped into the man called Jesus. Hallelujah. To come on earth to multiply sons. And the devil of all Simon, he really don't understand. The scripture says, had he known, he would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Because there is this man who lived for 33 years and a half years, walking, doing miracles. And guess what? They crucified him, but they did not know. The people couldn't see what the Messiah could be. They wanted a military ruler. They wanted a Superman. They wanted someone to deliver them from the Romans. But God sent Jesus into the womb of a virgin as a humble babe in a manger. And guess what? The eternal spirit was in him. So Christ is the eternal spirit. So when the eternal spirit, when Sharna gets to the altar and begins to cry out to God, God slays Sharna's old life in a split second. And Christ, the eternal spirit, takes her spirit and wraps it up in his spirit. Christ is eternal spirit that was with the Father from the world began. Jesus came to the earth as the Son of God, and those who are in him, hallelujah, their spirits have been joined to the Lord. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 17, he that is joined to the Lord is what? One spirit. So you can rejoice. Come on, you can rejoice all over. Your spirit was taken and put in an eternal spirit. And so the old time people understood it. They said, we are wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in Jesus. Hallelujah. And your soul and your spirit were supposed to stay in that safe place. Because God said, when I form you, who can pluck you out of my hand? Nobody can pluck you out. You have to crawl out. But if you don't have enough teachings, you will crawl out of that hand. Because God expected you to, your soul to stay anchored in that safe place. But guess what? We peep out of that secret place. And we look out into the world. And what we see in the world? The lust of the flesh. The lust of the eyes. And the pride of life. And picture a nice little lamb. Just born nice and white and pretty. And the rain is falling, and he has somebody who cares for him. They're going to curdle him and make sure he's okay. Right? Because he doesn't even understand who he is yet. Picture a nice white little pig, and the rain is falling, and outside muddy. What do you think the pig is going to want to do? Run outside and roll in the mud. Christianity is a change of nature. You got a new nature, and you pass from death to life. As fast as you bat your eye, you stepped into life. Hallelujah. And the principalities and the powers of darkness, they see. But they know that we have a weak church that is not going to build you up in the knowledge of God. And you can't blame some of the pastors. I've come to have compassion on pastors. They're simply teaching what they know. Some are wanton and teaching what they don't know. But Monisa, can you imagine yourself just born again and just happy on your way to heaven? You're steadfast. You're full of the joy of the Lord. Do you remember when you got saved? And you felt like you wanted to live forever. And you were meant to live forever. God put that in you. When you were born again, you tasted of the powers of the world to come. Hallelujah. And your spirit began to rejoice. But then you went to church and they told you, nobody is perfect. You will fall down. and you will get up. As a matter of fact, look in the world. Anything you can see, name it, claim it. So the word rebuilt the things that God destroyed in us. But every child of God that is born again is a perfect one. God's children have no birth defects. If you are born again, you have no birth defects. God does not have birth defects, children. But because we don't know that, we were created perfect in Christ. Every second, a perfect soul slips out. You think all his works are perfect? If all his natural creation that he created is perfect, how much more those who he would make after the order of Jesus? Why? To establish a priesthood. Believers who would not just leave prayer for the intercessors. So German is an intercessor, let him pray. So Keisha is the intercession. It's a whole nation of priests that offer sacrifices and gifts daily. And guess what? Every day the Lord, you work with people, you know, and every day the Holy Spirit is telling you there's a sacrifice you need to make and your gift needs to be offered up for that person to get saved. But because you're dull of hearing and because you have men's personage in admiration, you just leave her until the person have cancer and dying. That's the time you're rushing to them bedside when they are in so much pain they can't even hear you. God is raising up a nation of priests. Hallelujah. The priesthood has been changed. We are now after the order of Melchizedek. So we have the power of an endless life. What is this power though? It is power to become a son of God. John 1 verse 12. For as many as receive him, to them gave he what? Power to become a son of God. Even those that believe on his name. The power is to become a son. Why we think that the power is to get the natural things. The power is to become a son. Hallelujah. God has, and another scripture that proves his power, John 17 verse 2. And thou hast given him power over all flesh. Jesus has power over all flesh that he can give to as many as he wants eternal life. God, I want you to listen. God has given you the power of eternal life, the endless life. He that believeth on him shall never die. So you say, okay, but Christians die. The Son of God who is born again, they have already passed from death to life. And what happens when they are leaving here is that the chariots of the Lord swing low and pick them up. There's never a death angel in the room of a born again believer. They cannot come nearby. Death cannot touch them. They have passed from death to life. As a matter of fact, they don't die really as the natural man dies. What happens is that the spirit check out. So when your mother, when your father, when my father was going, what happened? As a matter of fact, he looked in a distant place, hallelujah, and saw life and began to declare life, life, life. The angels of the Lord encamp around them that fear him. Which demon can come near? None. It's the angels of the Lord that come for the spirit of the righteous. And to be absent from the body, they are immediately, as quicker than when you bat your eye, present with the Lord. That's why God said glorious. Because him see the chariot them. And him hear the song. And him see them going up into. Hallelujah. Just like Jesus, when Jesus was going up. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Hallelujah. Open up he gates. The King of glory is coming in. Yo. Who is this King of glory? What is the purpose of Christ though? What is the purpose of this spirit? It is to equip us to rule over the nations. God is raising up a nation of kings and priests. And he said to his apostles when he were here, If you are faithful, I'll give you 10 cities. If you are faithful, I'll give you 5 cities. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. God, give me whatever you have for me, give God. And if anybody put on anything careless, I don't want it. Help me to work for it so you can give me too. But Lord, more importantly, fix their heart, if peradventure. Because God is raising up a nation of kings and priests. And we will rule over the earth for 1,000 years initially, Lisa. Can you imagine? The whole 1/3 of the Bible has the kingdom set up in it. It runs throughout the scripture. Can you imagine when President Jesus steps in as the king of the earth, of the world, hallelujah, as the prince of peace, and ruling for 1,000 years? And he has made me, because he has planets and galaxies. God, my God is big enough. Come on, he's bigger than what people say. Come on, he's bigger than what people say. But him say, guess what? I've put glory in you. All the glory that I have, I've put it in you. But I've just wrapped it in a clay pot. Skin. So you're veiled. We are veiled in flesh. The scripture says if people knew us, who we were, if they just saw who we were, they wouldn't treat us at work. They would bow down and worship you. But God has veiled us in clay pots. That's the mystery of Christ. Christ is in you. Hallelujah. So what prevents this endless life from coming out to so many Christians have this endless life and not tapping into it from now? This life works by sacrifice. The gifts works by sacrifice. Which means to suffer for Christ. Because we are living in an upside down world and people are repulsed by nature, the children of wrath are by nature repulsed by the kingdom of light. When you shine, they take it personally. They don't. They might lash out at you. But guess what? When they see love, when they feel love, they don't know what to do with it. That's how they see the kingdom. For you to have this endless life, you must receive salvation. Everybody has been given natural life. I'm speaking to somebody now. Everybody has been given natural life. But eternal life is only in the Son. You know, God will use your life to write one scripture and then have raise up people to herald it. God used my Father to raise up one scripture to the world that will last till he comes. The record. The record. Right now, this conference is about the record of the power of the endless life in Christ. God says eternal life is in the Son. And guess what? People don't have a problem with God. God, they call him whatever they want. You ever hear people, God, oh my God, but they are offended at Jesus. Hallelujah, because he is the one who declares, you can't come to God no other way but by me. No man, everybody shout, no man. No man comes to the Father but by me. And here is this humble Jesus now stepping inside of us. And a neighbor is acting up and carrying crazy, or a boss at work is carrying crazy. And Jesus is testifying, no man come to the Father but by me. And God will make your enemy a footstool. But if you walk on them, he'll be a tool lick. When he makes them your footstool, when he humbles them, it's for you to run and serve them. I remember living with a neighbor who was really, really giving me some trouble. And then God, when she got ill, we were cooking for them every day. Serving, loving, caring. They were party freaks, you know. When they start, the whole house a shake at night time till morning. And one morning, one night I said, Andrew, let's go over there and deal with them. And I heard the Holy Spirit say, I will deal with you. And when the Holy Spirit filled them over there, they came running, skipping, praising the Lord, on fire for God. Sometimes the reason the world is not one Souls cannot be saved until they see Christ on display. The power of an endless life is the power to live holy. That's the power God gives us, the power to live holy, the power to live righteous, the power to love. So here are the saints of God, very religious. Enough prayer meetings. Hallelujah. Lord, we pray you will go down to Trench Town. Father, we pray you will blanket halfway tree. Lord, and we are praying and we are praying and we are praying, and God says, I need some bodies. I need some bodies that I can step in to lay hands so people can get eternal life. And every one of you here, there is a set amount of souls that are appointed for you to reach. Right, Lisa? I'm so happy that your friends are following you by the droves. Hallelujah. Follow Christ, because they will follow you into Christ. Hallelujah. That is why God set you among us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What prevents it endless, this, the realization of this endless life? When we don't forgive. When we don't forgive, we miss the essence of this eternal life. Now guess what? God has given us power, you know. But guess what? This is a whole nation of kings and priests. The power of an endless life is the resurrection power. The power that goes beyond this present world. Jesus says in Matthew 28 verse 18, all power is given to me. Hear Jesus, in heaven and earth. This means that God, means that whatever power God has been given to Jesus, and he has transferred this power to us. But we don't know. Because for this power to come out, we have to live holy. There's a new breed of priests arising in the earth today. It is the priesthood that Peter spoke about. This new breed of priests, they understand, like Pastor Andrew said last night, that the priesthood has been changed. It's no longer like Levi. It's the Judean priesthood. And hear what the Lord said about them. They are separate from sinners. What did he say about them again? They are holy. They are undefiled. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now God has given us dunamis. That the power that he has given us is called dunamis. It's an inherent power. It happens every time you obey God. Say you get up, Maurice, and you're going to work. And the Lord give you an instruction and you obey him. And the instructions that God gives the sons are real time. When you're walking in the spirit, everything you do is real time. Sometimes you don't hear a voice say, smile at the person. This is the body of Christ. Your face will smile. And that person was so depressed, and Christ will smile. And the person make a call to somebody in Zimbabwe. And that person calls somebody. And before you know, love is running out just from all over the world, just from you being a son of God. That is the dunamis power of God. We were called to walk in that power. Hallelujah. Jesus possessed an endless life. Hallelujah. In Matthew, in Revelation, he says that I am the Alpha and what? The Omega. I am the beginning and the end. God has called every one of you to partake of the power of this life, endless life. What does it look like when we want to walk in the power of the endless life? What does it look like, Tashima, when you walk in the power of this endless life? Those who are watching, what does it look like when you walk in the power of this endless life? I told you last night that the Lord gave me an experience last Friday. But when I look in my life, I don't know how much time I have. But whatever time I have, my life needs to be defined by one word, Christ. What is the meaning of Christ? The eternal spirit. Somebody shout eternal spirit. Come on, let's just worship that eternal spirit right now. Come on, hallelujah. We worship that eternal spirit. That spirit was the spirit that was with God in creation that brooded across the water. When God says, "Let us make man," that spirit was the spirit that stepped into earth on the day of Pentecost. Hallelujah. And like a rushing of a mighty wind. Hallelujah. That spirit filled you up. Do you remember when you got the Holy Ghost? When your spirit, hallelujah, that spirit stepped into your body. When that spirit stepped into your body, your hand went up. I don't know about you, but I was so excited. I was rolling on the ground. I didn't care who see me. And I was running around the church because that eternal spirit stepped into my body. Yes. Yeah, about Satan. Hallelujah. It's the power of an endless life. And guess what? God says, you know, I want you to experience this power. And you can experience this power every day. It was not meant to be when you just get filled. Hallelujah. It's an everyday. Every day. When you tap it. By the way, excuse me. You're a recreated spirit. And I'm encouraging you all to follow us as we teach the new creation series. Listen to all of them and take notes. That is our commission. I don't know when that's going to end, because every day the Lord writes a new one. When your spirit, Darren, your spirit, Chavel, your spirit, Mr. Stewart, is bigger than any technology and more advanced than any technology that will ever be created. No man can make the technology of your spirit. And besides that, after all of that, God said, I'm taking this technology. Said this is your spirit. God said, I'm wrapping it up in me. I'm holding it. Him wrap you in, your spirit in him, and then him hold you. But him said, one requirement may I give you. Get charged up every day. Charge your spirit. Charge your spirit with the word. Plug in. Plug in to me. As a matter of fact, with this one, you have to stay plugged in all the while. You can't disconnect. As a matter, and it's wireless. It's a technology that is more advanced than wireless. Hallelujah. Come on, we bless the Lord. Come on, we bless the Lord. Somebody shout power. 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 Endless life. We are decreeing and declaring and asking God to open the doors for this word to hit the nations. And the word hit the nations through a life that is walking pure. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Men live and die striving for power and control. Ultimately, they don't even realize that God says, all power is of God. Or every power that is raised up is ordained of God. Nobody can be prime minister without God saying, you are prime minister. All the powers that be are ordained of God. And yet some of us spend our lives and we're so green and we're so orange and we spend all the days of our lives working carnally. God says, guess what? Tap into the power of the age to come. Can you imagine? God gave you the power of the age to come. Somebody find the scripture there for me, please. Find that scripture and read it. The power, Pastor Mike around, we want to read it. The power of the age to come. God said, I'm giving you the power of the age to come. No. Hallelujah. The endless life that you have been given has been given the ability. Hallelujah. The power that God gives you is greater than any world superpower. Hallelujah. Our life is hid with Christ in God, and in him we have all the power over all. Hear God now? I have given you power over all the works of the devil. It don't matter if you see how the devil kick up. If you see the devil kill somebody, you don't know what's happening behind the scenes. If God has put you in that situation and say, pray for that gunman, you don't know how far your prayer going. Do you remember Stephen? Stephen standing up as a young deacon, and Paul standing up there and killing and stoning him, consenting for him to be killed. And then when you look up in heaven, Jesus was not seated at the right hand of the Father, you know. He was standing up Hallelujah. He was standing up and there was a light on his face that Paul was convicted, because Paul was a Pharisee of Pharisees. He knew the law. He was perfect in the law. But he did not understand the power of an endless life. Paul was the man who was in Romans 7 saying, when I would do good, evil is present. Even though I'm a work the law. Stop using that scripture out of context. That scripture is speaking of Paul, the unregenerated man. But in Romans 8, when him get life, him said, there is therefore no condemnation to me because I am in Christ. And guess what Paul came to see? That there are two laws working in the earth. The law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus and the law of sin and death. Two laws. God is the best physicist you can think about, chemist, biologist. He said, I have two laws working. You're an engineer, you understand laws. So in everybody's flesh is either the law of sin and death or the law of the spirit of life. When you are born again, God take out the law of sin and death out of you and install a new law. But if you don't know that it is there, you continue doing what you want to do. And guess what? The spirit, that body will never ever sin again unless you take the spirit to carry it into sin. And so God said, you will have to give account for every deed that you have done. But then hear God now. Guess what? You're my son and you come to me. When you come to me, as far as the east is from the west, I have removed your transgression. As a matter of fact, I put it in a sea of forgetfulness. And I don't remember it anymore. So when the devil comes to plague you, once you know from your heart that you were sincere and God don't have it on your book, the devil will even write it for years that it's on your book. When God made it clean. Put your hands together. Hallelujah. Read that scripture for me, please.
Hebrews chapter 6 verse 5 reads, and have tasted the good word of
God. Read the word before that.
Okay. Verse 4. For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Ghost and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come.
Excuse me, it is impossible to renew people. Why? Because there's only one sacrifice. There's no more sacrifice for sin except the one. So anybody who fall, you have to go back and repent and believe in that one sacrifice. That sacrifice carry life. One drop of blood, of Jesus' blood, is the remedy. That's the true blood remedy, Pastor Andrew. Hallelujah. And that blood is still fresh. 2,000 years ago, Chavelle. And that blood is still, hallelujah, running warm in our veins. And guess what? When that blood drop on your soul, the Bible says it will purge your guilty conscience and set you free. And guess what? That blood, hallelujah, the work of that blood makes you a brand new creation with an endless life. Hallelujah. How did Jesus tap into this life? What's the difference for us? He got up every day praying to his Father. Get back to the word. Some of you here, there is a power in this conference to put you on a word track for the rest of your life. To get up every day and get plugged into the word. Hallelujah. You have to pray. If you do not have a relationship with God, anything of value will become God to you. If you do not have a relationship with God, with anything of value will become a God to you. Hallelujah. You do not get humble by trying. God is calling us to humble ourselves so we can live out of that power. It is by having and embracing a vision of God's greatness. Hallelujah. When you do, you know how many people looking at their mess? You'll never get delivered looking at your mess. It is when you lift up your eyes to the hills from whence come your help. By the way, I don't know why the devil trick us to walk in pride. Don't you know that God is waiting with open arms? Some people over the world all right now, condemnation, guilt, and he's just saying, come on, look to me and be saved. All ye ends of the earth, look to me. Hear God saying to the scriptures, look to me. But pride causes us not to look to God. So we spend, can you imagine, there are men tonight who have multi-million dollar businesses and they are caught up. That's why the Bible says the love of money is the root of all evil. And men are drowning, hallelujah. They can't carry it. Some of them are writing a will to their dog, to will millions to their dog. That's how deceived men are. But it takes a certain anointing to chop the rich loose, hallelujah. And when, because if you want anything from them, guess what, you will never win them. Somebody gave me a challenge to collect $30,000 just before the conference. I said, I don't want your money. I am in for your soul. You will be tested. You will be tried. When I take your $30,000 and spend it, you can't pay me $1 billion to even listen to 1 minute of carnal secular song intentionally. My salvation is worth more than anything this world can offer. Hallelujah. And nobody can buy me. You need to get to that place where you say, Lord, come on, lift up your hands. I have tasted of the powers of the world to come. And I don't want nothing to bind me. That's why we must have a culture of prayer and a time in the word as our lifestyle. Righteousness is a nature that begets righteousness. The world, Jamaica is struggling because righteousness begets righteousness. He that doeth righteous is righteous. And I believe that God has raised up a priesthood across the globe. There are many apostolic prophetic houses that are across the globe. And he is doing a work in this time that is causing people to stand up in Christ. Now there's one thing that the devil hates, because it's the mechanism for you to tap into that power you have. The devil hates discipleship and prayer meeting. He hates discipleship. Because he knows it's the word that is going to get in your spirit. And when that word gets in your spirit, guess what it becomes? A sword in the spirit that quenches all the fiery darts of the enemy. He's trembling if you start wanting to come to prayer. He hates Bible study and discipleship. Lest you be equipped. Because discipleship is causing you to tap into the power of the world to come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Lift up your hands to the Lord. Hallelujah. This endless life is powerful. Hallelujah. And as I said, for those who didn't listen this morning, God has eternal life and everlasting. There are some people who will walk in everlasting life because they were not a part of the church age. And they will eat of the tree of life and live forever. But eternal life is the God kind of life. It's the Zoe life. Hallelujah. When God is made flesh in you. So God prophesied to the prophets, I want to have a people. I will walk in them and I'll talk in them real time. It doesn't want us to be looking back to say, what would Jesus do? Oh my God. No, he says, I will walk in them. I will talk in them. Even before you, while you are yet speaking. He's in your mouth. He says, I don't want you to climb up to heaven and try to pull me down. Oh, I'm in you. I'm in your heart. Somebody shout, Christ in you. Christ in you. Say, Christ in you. Christ in you. You know what the Lord said to me Friday? He said that, guess what? I've been teaching in Bible school for a long time. Both of us, a whole heap of different Bible schools. And he began to make me feel compassion for the young people. And he said, until you can get them to settle and begin to break the word, a lot of them will go off. He said, remember how you were formed. I went to Bible Training Institute of the Church of God of Prophecy as a young person in college and went to the 3 years. I went to Christian International Bible School, Apostle Bill Hammond, right? I went to Bible Teachers Bible School. I went to JTS. I've always just wanted the Bible. And I teach the Bible to many people. Some of my JTS students, we still have that good connection. But God says, do you think I'm raising you up to just go to high school conferences? And they just dance all day? That's a part of it. That might be the calling card. He says, no. I want you to sit down with them and break the word. You know why I'm encouraged? I went to St. Catherine High and saw you for the first time in your life. I went to Port Antonio High School Conference and saw you for the first time in your life. Some of you, I've met you on the school and church platforms. And God says it's time. So we're going to be doing Word Vibes teaching conferences for young people. And God says set them up. If a 10 come, work with the 10. Call them out. Pour into them. We have some awesome teachers in this ministry. Because guess what? What Pastor Andrew said last night, that God has been saying, stop calling the young people generation of vipers. That was for the Pharisees. They are not a generation of vipers. They are just looking for direction. And you can't use age against me. I'm forever young. I've tapped into the power of an endless life. And even if God could say to Moses, as your days be, so shall your strength be. Them people that walk for 40 years and them clothes never rotten and them shoes never wear out. 40 years and then clothes and shoes grow with them. Do you see what, by the way, do you know that God wants to unveil what he means by endless life to us? This thing can be mega. If God ever show you what endless life is to you, you never spend a day outside of his presence. You need to start saying, Lord, show me your way. Show me your way. So I'm not bothered by age because my spirit is young. My spirit is in Jesus, and guess what? It's wrapped up. And you don't have to worry about reaching. When Christ is in you, anybody you want you to reach, you can reach. Because that's Christ. So don't worry about, I'm too young, I'm a child. No. God can carry you to a business meeting with businessmen. As we wrap up tonight, I'm calling, as Pastor Andrew said, don't get excited preaching to the world. Yes. And don't remember those who are in front of you. This conference is for you. God is conferring with you. We are believing God that some of the songs that come out of these teachings will hit the globe in 24 hours. And we are those who are going to say, are you alone? Forget the glory, God. Nobody else. You see what God is doing? He's sending musicians. And he's sending those who are listening to the word. Chavel, when you hear God start, just take the notes and start walk it. And you know what God is doing? He's sending these young people in among the harvest. This thing mega, you know? You can't feel, you know? He that believeth on me shall never die. Somebody shout, never die. You cannot die. You just pass through your pilgrims. Is sweetie? Jesus, sweetie, man. Hallelujah. Wow. Wow. This word is so powerful that I am shuddering to see what God is going to do. Because guess what? You know, God wants to talk to all of us. We have begun to pray the Pauline prayers, that the spirit of honest, of revelation and wisdom. And so I'm encouraging all of you, get a little book or your phone by your bedside. Start a group by yourself. Word Vibes. Me. Whatever God tell you. Because sometimes he visits you and he says something to you, and by the morning you don't remember. Don't be too lazy. I keep a book beside my bed, and he's talking. Oh, you think these messages come? You think Mr. Wise? Now unto the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Somebody call Jesus. Mr. Wise. What he speaks, you talk to a speaking God. And you, and by the way, no matter say something, tell me. Don't insult his intelligence. If you have the Holy Ghost, he wants to talk to you. So just get up and just write what he said. And we want interactive Bible studies and interactive discipleship because we want to hear your increase. The Lord give you a song. The family, get up and go to the studio. The power of an endless life. But there are some things that block this power. If you have unforgiveness on your heart, this power won't flow. Iniquity stops the flow of love. Hallelujah. If you are lusting after something that God has said you can't get, you won't get this power. You have to want nothing but God. And then he hooks you up to this eternal power. Now this power is, let me tell you how powerful this world is. Do you see this sun? The sun is powered by the sun. This S-U-N is powered by S-O-N. He holds all things by the word of his power. It's not JPS you're talking about. He powers every form of every. By him were all things created that was made. And without him is nothing made that was made. You're talking about God, the source of all power, the source of all wisdom, the source of all strength. Shift easy. Shift into a new place. Hallelujah. Stop, as I said before, something today in that little time of question and answer. Stop envying Samson. A greater than Samson is here. When Jesus is in you, you are stronger than Samson, Paul. When Jesus is in you, you are wiser than Solomon. Jesus Christ is made to me all I need. So I'm addressing someone online now. Whatever you need, I'm not saying want. Whatever you need, God is. If you need a father, he's a father to the fatherless. If you need a friend, he's a friend to the friendless. If you are in need of financial help and you just can't help, and it's not for wantonness, guess what? He is Jehovah Jireh. If you are sick in your body, hallelujah, he will heal you. Hallelujah, he will heal you. You're talking about God. Hallelujah. If you don't know what you want, hallelujah. If your mind is so confused, he said, guess what? Stop paying that whole heap of money running up and down. You are a Christian. I will keep you in perfect peace. That's my mental health strategy. If you keep your mind stayed on me. When was the last time you woke up, hallelujah, and grabbed your Bible and opened it? And that is why, you know, I'm compassionate about the people of God. I want to teach you how to study the Bible. And there are courses that taught me. I'm not going to reinvent the wheel. I'm pulling them from every source, adding to them, and saying, hey, look at this. This is how you study the Bible. This is how you pray. Because it's one life. Hallelujah. Somebody say the power of an endless life. Aren't you blessed? Aren't you blessed? Hallelujah. I feel like running. I feel like skipping. I feel like praising the Lord for what he has done for me. What did he do for me? Hallelujah. My spirit was bound. Hallelujah. If you know what a bound spirit look like, can you imagine Satan gag somebody and that those greyback demons tormenting that spirit, and that spirit is rolling, it has everything in the world but is tormented, and the only thing that can deliver that spirit from the grip of the devil is the word. And the word, not just the Bible, but you. Do you know that people who are ripe for the harvest are miserable? Why? Because they are ripe. The person is ripe. That is why God putting them in your life to antagonize you. And he's hoping that you would have compassion on the ignorant and the out of the way. You have experienced that power of an endless life. He wants others to experience that life through you. I'm asking God out of this conference to give me a fresh appreciation of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. I'm hungry for more of Him, because He fills the hungry with good things. It's not that God wants you to just be hungry every day, but guess what? He says that, guess what? When you are, I am the one who will cause you to want more. Hallelujah. Because God, He gives you everything, you know, but He wants to release. Somebody say release. How many of you, God, you want God to release more understanding? Come on, lift up your hands. More, hallelujah, more. By the way, everything is in you, but He wants to release more love. How is He going to release more love? By setting up an enemy in your life for that love to flow. It's the power of an endless life. I wonder if there's someone tonight who is saying, I need prayer. I need to be saved. If you're online, I want you to communicate online. I want to be saved. I need the Holy Ghost. I need to be renewed in the spirit of my mind. I'm hearing all this talk about the power of an endless life. I want to tap into that power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, we are going to go up before the Lord now in prayer. If you need prayer all around, just lift up your hands to the Lord. If you need prayer, if you need God to wash you afresh, if you need God to sanctify you afresh, if, hallelujah, if you need to be saved, fall down on your knees where you are all over. But those online, this is not just a pretty talk. Hallelujah. You are going to live forever with the devil or live forever with God. But God has promised you the power of an endless life, the power to walk right, the power to talk right, the power to live holy. Hallelujah. Somebody shout power. Hallelujah, the power to become a son of God. Hallelujah. 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 Can we go before the Lord with that song of praise, Sister Verona? Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on.
I'm desperate for you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Without Him. Watching online, God wants you to come to a place of hallelujah, helpless dependency, for Him to give you the power to become a son of God. Hallelujah, you need to be desperate for Him. Hallelujah, cry out to Him. Cry out to Him. Cry out to Him.